Good evening. I need to shave. Tonight I'll be using the J.R. Torrey Army Razor. I sharpened it with my translucent black Arkansas stone. Sucker's sharp. Better watch myself with that razor. And we'll be using Wild West Shave Company White Buffalo. Gardenia and sandalwood. And we will use the Silver Tip Badger, the two-band Silver Tip Badger. Should be good. Stay tuned. Okay, just took a shower, got that Fomunda smell off of me. Armpits no longer smelling like musty old dirty onions. Let's make some lather. I'll just start with a spoonful of water here. Out of my scuttle. Get the brush ready. Here we go. This soap here really smells good. I really, really like this soap. Performs great. It's one of my favorites. Everything about it. Especially like the smell of gardenias. And sandalwood. The gardenia smell in this soap is a little stronger than the sandalwood, which is fine with me. Gardenia is great. Just gonna start loading up a little more here. Definitely gonna need more water. I'm guessing maybe 3 spoonfuls here. It's a fairly thirsty soap. I still like to add the water gradually. And one thing I noticed with this soap, just about any one of the scents from Wild West Shave Company, is that it will give you a great lather real quick, and you'll be like, woohoo, yeah, look at that. But if you're patient with it, and you give it a good minute and a half or 2 minutes or so, you'll get a really good lather. So, or even more. I just like to just keep going until I see that lather. So you have a little experience with this soap, you'll understand what I mean. You'll be like, up, there it is. Put a little more water. Not quite 3 tablespoons. There it is. Give that a shot. Put a lot of soap in here. This brush is a big lather hog. Lather badger, whatever. It's a badger, not a hog. The bristles are really soft. It feels really nice on your face. It's more or less probably a better brush if you're a face latherer. This was a Razo Rock Monster, which was synthetic bristles. But it just wasn't for me. I took those bristles out and I got myself a silver tip knot for under 30 bucks. I don't know what I pay for. Now it's a silver tip. Let's see what we got here. It's looking pretty good. Kind of like that. I'm a little on the drier side. I kind of like it like that on the drier side. Maybe just, I mean, I could put a little bit more water or I could just leave it alone, but it's starting to get there to where it's like, get that nice lather that I was talking about. See, we're about 3 minutes in right now. So yeah, it's probably done. I think I'm gonna leave it at that just to be safe. I don't like my lather too watery. That's a lot of lather. That'll work. There it is. I'm not gonna use all that at once. Man, this stuff is awesome. It just feels so fluffy and slick. This soap has awesome residual slickness. It's got that bentonite clay in it. All my favorite soaps have that. It's almost essential. There's a few soaps that I can use without bentonite clay, but they'd probably be better if it had it. It's like, it's just a key ingredient for slickness. All right, not bad. Got this razor a while back on eBay. I don't remember what I got for it, but it says Army on it. I don't know if, I don't know what that's about, but maybe somebody who was in the Army owned it. Probably someone's grandpa. I don't know. It's got character though. I think it's probably not, I would doubt if it's, it's probably older than World War II, I imagine. Oh. I've acquired quite a few sharpening stones over the past few months, and I've had some honeymoons with them, honeymoons with other ones. For a while, the Black Arkansas, the Black Translucent, was my baby. Until I got my 8x3 caudical. I haven't really touched the Arkansas stone. But this one has the Arkansas edge. The Arkansas edge is definitely sharper than the caudical edge. But it's kind of tears up my skin. So, here's what I came to. When I haven't shaved for like 3 or 4 days, I use the Hyper Edge, the Arkansas stone. And when I've shaved one day, if I keep giving myself baby smooth like every day, oh, baby smooth, it starts to get a little sore. So I think the caudical edge is much better for that. The caudical edge just feels great. This one here has got a little bit of bite to it. But it does a great job. The one thing I haven't tried is giving the razor a caudical edge. And this maybe polishing up with the Arkansas a little bit, just kind of give it that extra edge, if you will. We'll see. Maybe I'll report back on that. Make a video. So far, skin's feeling pretty good. This edge is doing a great job. I don't feel any irritation. But that might be because of the soap. Soap is so good. And I love the smell of them gardenias and sandalwood. It's not that strong, but it's strong enough, just enough. It doesn't need to be stronger. It doesn't need to be weaker. It's like perfect. All right, there's the first pass. Just like butter. I notice with these old razors, you look at the angle of the bevel on these suckers, and they're steep, usually like 13 degrees. So like this one here, I sharpened it without any tape or anything, and then got an awesome edge on it. I went to shave with it, and I was like, damn, that thing was harsh. What the hell happened? So I looked at it underneath the jeweler's loop, and the edge was trashed. So I attributed that to the angle, probably, you know, so you got a steep angle like that. It's not going to hold an edge, like even through your shave. I had to use two pieces of tape with this to get it to like 17. It might have turned out to be like 17.5 or something on that angle. Gonna go up on this. So if you're having that problem with these razors, you know, calculate your bevel angle. You have apps on your phone and stuff, resources you can use to calculate that. You definitely feel this edge a lot more than my caudal edges. Might even be a little blood somewhere. A mustache is the most sensitive spot on my face. See, it's bleeding already. Those hairs go straight down. It's okay. I think I'll just leave it at that. I'm not gonna go for a third pass on the stash. Now, notice it's harder to shave on camera, and when you're using a razor as sharp as this one. Yeah, it's easy to nick yourself a little bit. I got some cuts, but I'm gonna have to just, it's already bleeding through. My cuticle edges don't do that. But I could already feel it. It's just, I don't know. Just gotta go easy on the Arkansas. If I go there, I think just not spend too much time on it, because that sucker, I don't know, just gets it so sharp. I do the hanging hair chaz, like ting, 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 ting. It's crazy. Just cuts through it like a hot knife through butter. Not even sure if I should be doing this pass. It's pretty close already. Just a little cleanup. Whatever. Sideways on the mustache. My mustache is clean. Yeah, that's good. That's good enough. I'll slap on some aftershave and call it a night. If you're curious of what kind of aftershave I'm gonna use, I think I'm gonna use Skin Bracer because it's nighttime. I don't have to show off to anybody today. So y'all have a good night. Try to keep the skin on your face, and have a great day tomorrow. Bye-bye.